joining us for our anatomy and physiology STEM session. We're revisiting an interview with one of our favorite alums, Dr. Kathy Berentis, a molecular biologist and microbiologist working at PPD in Richmond, Virginia. As a senior group leader, Dr. Berentis leads a team to develop and validate immuno and cell-based assays supporting preclinical and clinical trials for drugs for cancer, viral infections, and rare genetic disorders. She also developed assays for COVID antibody assessments in 2020. In her original alumni survey, Kathy said that Science Olympiad was a big part of her decision to major in biology in college. Her prep for bio events was an excellent foundation for her college courses. She now encourages Science Olympiad participants to branch out and try lots of different events. Even though she wound up following bio pathways, she loved astronomy and chemistry events too. This year, our anatomy and physiology subtopics are the nervous and endocrine systems and sense organs. These subjects literally touch us all and affect our daily lives. If you study the nervous system, you'll cover topics of sleep and dreams and how substances like caffeine impact wakefulness. We all know that looking at your phone before bed can interrupt deep sleep patterns due to the effect of blue light on the production of melatonin. But did you know which social media app is the most disruptive to sleep? An extremely non-scientific study conducted by the website Sleep Junkie concluded that TikTok was the most detrimental to a good night's rest. Makes sense, right? Also related to sleep, mood, and disease is the endocrine system, which regulates hormones, something we are all familiar with in Science Olympiad. And did you see the latest development in treating vision loss? Most adults over the age of 45 have problems with close range vision. And the FDA just approved a new daily eye drops that can replace reading glasses by making the pupil smaller. If you keep working on your STEM skills, amazing discoveries like these could be in your future too. Now let's listen in as Dr. Berentis tells us about her favorite Science Olympiad memories and shares advice on how to make the most out of a career in science.
I currently live in Richmond, Virginia, and I'm going to briefly share a little bit about my background in science, which actually began with Science Olympiad. So my current role, just a little bit about that. So I'm a group leader at PPD, which is Pharmaceutical Product Development. And what we do is we help develop life-saving drugs, so for infectious diseases or cancer treatments. And we help work together with other companies to set up clinical trials. And then so we'll test patient samples and make sure that these new therapies are safe and effective in the patients. So I find it really exciting. Because we get to work on things like, of course, COVID, but other really important diseases that there may be no cure for, or there's not a lot of therapies like pancreatic cancer. So I would consider myself mostly a molecular biologist and a microbiologist. So I like studying the small sides of biology. And I first became interested in that through Science Olympiad, actually. So I was always interested in some parts of science and possibly engineering. But when I was in middle school, I had a great science teacher who was turned out to be one of the coaches of the Science Olympiad team. And they got me really excited in my biology class. I like really learning about cells and plants and things like that. And I also participated in a summer program where we got to go into the stream and look for aquatic insects. And I love that too. And so through them, I got involved in Science Olympiad. So in middle school and then in high school. And so in middle school, I actually did a water quality event, which relates to the aquatic insects, so that was a nice tie-in. And I learned about a whole bunch of things that I never had really thought about before. Like I did an event called Road Scholar, where we were looking at topographic maps and road maps, and I thought that was really fun. And I continued that into my high school. So I really became solidified on biology as a career at that point, because I did a lot of the biology events. So I did cell biology, designer genes, bioprocess lab. Those were all very biology heavy. But I also learned about earth science and some other, and chemistry and some other fields that really interested me too. And that tied in nicely with my high school science teacher. I had a whole bunch of different biology classes. One of them was botany, was actually my favorite. And I remember learning about all the different types of flowers, and my teacher brought in this one flower that actually smelled like rotting meat, which I thought was really interesting. And it was pollinated by a fly. And I still remember that as being just a moment where how cool the living world can be. And that really, that combined all my experiences with Science Olympiad and the excitement. I really loved that working together and competing at state and national tournaments with my partners and just mastering these concepts. You know, that led me to become a biology major in college. So I went on to, it's a little bit about my educational background. I got my bachelor's degree in biology. And at that point, I started doing some research that was at Penn State University. And so I really learned about the molecular components. So those components inside the cell that, you know, make the whole cell work. And I really enjoyed that. And then in graduate school, I went to the University of Wisconsin, where I continued in molecular biology, and I became more interested in microbes as well. So I studied bacteria, and I became really interested in the interplay between bacteria and our bodies and, you know, infectious diseases. And that's really been a theme throughout my career. So I've studied a whole bunch of different types of things related to the body. I've studied bacteria that can make us sick. I studied bacteria called Brucella that actually can spread from different livestock species and then also make humans ill. And I got to do some interesting work in collaboration with folks with the government. I also got a chance to go to India as part of my work and collaborate with some exciting scientists there, some excellent scientists. So science can really take you all kinds of places. I said I love the research part, but I also like the people part. I love working together with a team. I like meeting people. It's very international. Get to meet excellent scientists from around the world. And, you know, I just love the process of communicating about it, too. So one thing I've gotten a chance to do, and I think Science Olympiad is really important in this, is I've been really involved in science outreach, so communicating with the public about science. It could be something like giving a talk about your research or doing a hands-on station, extracting DNA from wheat with people at a, you know, science fair. And I think the Science Olympiad was really important because when I was an undergraduate, I got a chance to start becoming a Science Olympiad coach. And I think that was my first experience doing science education and outreach. And I actually continued that later. So when I was at University of Wisconsin, I was a coach for a high school team there. And I was really passionate about that because it's really exciting to see, you know, you're excited about science and to get other people excited about science too. They're learning things and also testing, because that's what a lot of what science is about. It's not just learning facts, but the most important thing is understanding how you can think like a scientist and discover new things. And then I think, you know, over time, you kind of figure out what parts, excuse me, of science you're most interested in. And I said, I kind of found my niche. And over the years, I've really become involved in infectious diseases because I really like that. You know, I like the fact that we can develop new therapies to help people. I mean, obviously there's a lot of emerging diseases that are incredibly important and that public health component. So that's definitely an area if you're interested in public health and helping people. I think infectious diseases, infectious microbiology can be a really great one that intersects with some of the elements like anatomy and physiology and things like that. So overall, I mean, what I would say to someone who is maybe in middle school or high school doing Science Olympiad, explore a whole bunch of different fields. So try different events. You know, I love learning about astronomy and other earth sciences. That might not be my current focus, but all of the information you're gonna integrate. So I do a lot of things with chemistry and physics every day, and it's just fun to learn about. So some of the things I learned about in Science Olympiad with astronomy, I still remember, and some, you know, things you can do as a hobby, so that's fun. And so learn as much as you can, and definitely, you know, so practice working together and meeting new people. It's a really fun thing. I remember going to the nationals events and swap meet, and we would swap hats. My team in Wisconsin would have the cheese hats, and we would all swap those. So that was fun. So I enjoyed that. So enjoy those components too, because, you know, it's a process. You know, some of it is the competition, but I said really what I got out of it lasted throughout my whole career. So the medals and things like that, that's only one component of it. I know that what I learned as a biologist gave me a really strong foundation, not just in my studies, but then also in my career. And so I really, so happy that I would participate in that. And I'm excited to know that others are participating in Science Olympiad to this day. And I hope you get as much out of it as I did and enjoyed as much as I did.
What a great interview. I especially loved hearing how much Dr. Marentes enjoys the collaborative aspects of her work as a microbiologist. and how much she brings the lessons from Science Olympiad into her job every day. I hope this interview inspires you and motivates you to explore the topics of anatomy and physiology in your own and try some of the activities and lessons that we have in the free lesson plans and guides we posted to the MySO page. Have a great month, and thanks for tuning in.